Who's ready for some hot? Hi, everybody. James Sabowski for EA Sports. We are set to drop the puck on some Hockey Ultimate Team. Both teams are lined up, and we are set to get things going. Great night for hockey, and we are officially underway.
Cliche in hockey is you want to start the game hard and physical and really set the tone, and that's what he was doing right there.
There's the whistle as the puck is frozen up. We're still in the early stages of this period. The game is still scoreless. And they'll start with possession. The Oilers move the puck in the defensive zone. Edmonton's on the attack. Here he is, shot right in front. Oh, what a stop on the play. Gets all of it with the paddle.
When the goaltender reads the play quickly, James, and they anticipate, they get to position quicker. When they get to position quicker, they get squared to the shooter. That's exactly what he does here as he turns the wrist to his side.
Edmonton's got the puck on the board. He got all of that one. Fires it on net. Play blown dead. Let's get the call. The Maple Leafs are off to the box. Interference the call. Edmonton's man advantage unit will take to the ice for the first time tonight.
Well, as the defense, you never want to see this line come out here. Top-rated power play unit in the league. They have such efficient execution skills. The ability to get a puck off quickly and tremendous motion.
Edmonton's got it along the wall. Here's a short pass to Nabushkin. The Oilers have it from their own end. Shot makes the save.
Great positioning by the goaltender to redirect it to the puck. Oh, that's going to be a call, James. That's definitely a penalty.
Cut feed to Carlson. Here's the chance to take advantage with the delayed penalty. They've got the extra attacker on the ice. And here's the pass. A chance in the rush here. Edmonton's power play unit puts their hard hats on as they go back to work.
They haven't scored on the power play yet, but they have another opportunity. The key to this one, gain possession so they can set up.
Moves it to Horton, and it's a quick pass to Matthews. Rocks him on the play. One-on-one with the goaltender.
Oh,
scores! And they got ahead, and it comes short-handed.
Well, and that's just a dagger, isn't it, James? Being aggressive, anticipating an active stick, and getting on your horse and creating opportunity when you're on the PK. That's what you call taking advantage of a fortuitous rebound, and you have to be able to smell it and sniff it out because he has great hand-eye coordination to be able to pick that one up and put it in the back of the net.
The Maple Leafs have taken a 1-0 lead here past the midway mark in the opening frame.
It hasn't been easy to get here, has it? We haven't seen any offense in this game, and they get the first one, and they have to find a way to continue. Where there's one, you got to try and find two, continue to attack.
Takes the bump, but hangs on. Oh, my, you can feel that from here.
And the will on this goal, James. You get going north, you're a power forward, and you find a way to take the real estate that's given to you. Everyone becomes puck focused, knowing they have to honor you, knowing they have to try and take you away, and then you deliver a beautiful pass, which winds up in the back of the net.
And now it's grabbed by Riley. Broken up by Shabbat. Uses the force on that hit. The Maple Leafs played along the boards. Looking to win this draw, this man advantage here. Edmonton win off that draw. Passes it over to Hall. Things start to get a little physical out there. There's a shot. Oh, gets a glove on it to make the stop. Tucker's recognizing they're still shorthanded here as they get ready for the faceoff. The Maple Leafs win the draw. More time off the clock as they grab the puck. Nice zone entry from the right side. Picks up with the stop. Takes the feed at the point. Both teams back to even strength, and after giving up a shorthanded goal, it's an opportunity the power play unit would probably sooner forget.
Big question here, James, is what are you going to do next? You gave up a shorty. You got to find a way to get back in the game. What I mean by that is you have to reset, not just physically, but emotionally and mentally, and get back on track.
In the final moments of this period, we got a tie game. The Maple Leafs come up with a defensive zone draw. Looks to set up at the point now. Fires it! Only got a piece of it to keep it out. Moments away from the faceoff, let's get back to the action. The Oilers take possession here inside the offensive zone. Moves it quickly over to Horton. Oh, what a save on the slapper! Great reach with the stick by Fiala. Borks playing along the line. Puts it on net, and he gets a piece of that one and denies it. Big stop just as time expires in the period. There's the horn. Still 40 more minutes left in regulation time. We'll get to the second period right after this.
The Maple Leafs are sitting in a good position considering the first period that they had, James, where they turned over the puck constantly. They need to hit the reset button and look to get some motion, look to make good first pass decisions, and try and create some opportunities.
Gains the zone from the right side. Here's a shot. Long jam in front. That's broken up. Quick pass to Marchand. Moves inside and makes the save.
He's able to make a clean save on that wrister, James. A quick release shot, and he's square to it.
Takes a bump, but still hangs on to the puck. Borks taking it from his own end. The Maple Leafs take possession in the defensive end. Slides the puck into the offensive zone. And the traffic jam in front blocks the shot. And a strong effort on that play. He got all of that hit. The Maple Leafs gain possession. They are really starting to apply the pressure here in the offensive end. Coming down the left wing and into the zone. The Maple Leafs gain possession along the wall. On the attack along the boards. With the stop. And the goaltender grabs that one for a whistle to try to slow things down here. Past the halfway mark of this period, it's all tied up. possession here inside the offensive zone. Scooped up along the wall by Shabbat. Shot attempt completely fails on that. Denies that opportunity. Moves the puck inside the offensive zone. From the point, they take control of it. Pavelski's got it along the wing. Denies him in close.
That's a great save, but the goaltender had to get out to the top of his crease, take away all the ice, and make himself as big as possible.
Here in the late going to the frame, you can feel the energy in this crowd. It's a tie game. Edmonton's got it in the offensive zone. Receives the pass. And now he angles it across to Carlson. And sends it just out of reach. Feeds the puck to Greenway. Takes the shot. Oh, at the buzzer, a big save. Well, there you go. 40 minutes in the books. All right, friends, go grab yourself some water, get hydrated, and then buckle up because we got an exciting third period coming up in moments.
Icing the call, big face-off looming.
McCabe's able to get things going when he delivers that hard slap shot from the point, guys. This thunderclap zone ability gives him the edge when he has the chance to wind up and shoot, even from afar. He puts everything he has behind that shot.
Quick pass to Matthews. Moves the puck over to McDavid. Gets the puck in deep. The Maple Leafs will play the puck from behind the net. McCabe stick handling in his own zone. And that play's broken up. And he takes the feed. Moves it on over to McDavid. The Maple Leafs look to start the transition game. Takes the feed at center and moves up ahead. Close save, but he made it look simple. Tendy plays it up, and he slides it quickly to McDavid. The Maple Leafs have it now. And he takes the pass. The Oilers pick up the puck here in the neutral zone. Grabbed in the open ice by Fiala. Along the half wall with the puck. Blocked in front. Puck grab by Edmondson. The Oilers have it against the wall. Here's a short pass to Fiala. Moves it to the middle. Oh, and he comes up with a stop. The Maple Leafs move to the offensive zone. Nylander's got it to the side. Fiala's got it in the defensive end. Cuts into the paint. Oh, what a save on the play.
Such an athletic save, James. I mean, that's just all about compete and finding a way to get to the puck. Well, he knew where this puck was going. He's got a book on the shooter, James, and he gets square in front, great position, and makes the save.
They're going to keep things moving here.
Shoot it!
And they go back on the attack in the offensive zone.
Well, we've played three periods of regulation hockey and still no winner. So what do? We go to overtime. It's sudden death style. Will there be a hero? We'll find out next. Underway here with the puck drop. Matthews won the draw and they'll start off on the attack. Quick feed to Horton. From one point man to another. Centering feed! And he denies that great opportunity there. Tries to the crease. Looking to end it. Feeds it down low. Spectacular stop by the goaltender. How did he hang on to that? Oh, here we go. You knew that was coming.
Tempers are flaring now. You don't shoot that puck after the whistle unless you're sending a message. And you know, James, that you're going to have to answer for it. Over to the penalty box, still chirping one another. You can see that it was testy out there, but they'll go back to the box and they'll sit for five.
A lot on the line here in this offensive zone faceoff. Barbashev's won a big draw on their own end. Coffey's got the puck in his own zone. Slick feed. And there's the horn. This has been a fun one tonight. Still no winner to pick, so we'll take it to a shootout next.
James, goaltenders want work on this, so do shooters. He does a great job of anticipating to make that save.
makes a save and look good doing that one.
Yeah, the body language, everything about him is telling you that he's confident and composed right now.
Well, that bonus point is still up for grabs here for either side. The question is, who wants it? The answer is, and he says, on that play.
Yeah, the shootout, he's confident and composed. You don't see him moving around in his crease, just makes himself as big as possible. Looks really efficient.
So here's one of the hardest things about a shootout. Alright. Now that we're off the ice. See, the thing is, you can have, like, the most... How do I put it? One second. Respond to something after my stream. That'll be important. Now, if you have a great game, okay, and it's going, everything is going back and forth and back and forth, right? Everything, all your hard work, like let's say you were down two goals. I've been down two goals, right? Or even three goals, say for instance, alright? And you're going into the third, and let's say you work your ass off and you score goals and you get your goals back, right? And you tie the game, you worked so hard for it, and you get to overtime, right? And overtime can be done in one shot. One shot. One shot decides. One goal decides the game. That's right. All your hard work can get tossed into the toilet, and they'll hit the flush button, and you can watch it disappear. I shit you not. Right? You'll be gone just like that. Or, actually, I think about it, there's something much, much worse than overtime, right? And it's called the shootout. Yeah, the shootout will sometimes give me a fucking heart attack. Yep. Sometimes I think I'm gonna have a heart attack in the shootout. As if being in overtime isn't stressful enough, okay? And let's say nothing gets resolved in overtime, well, then they're dragging your ass to a shootout. And then things are getting interesting. As if they're not already enough. Looks like we're heading to Carolina. Buckle up, everybody. This will likely get violent. Someone's gonna get thrown through the boards. Oh yeah. Guaranteed. I got a mouth and temper. Let's do this. Told you we're warriors and animals on the ice. Friends off and we get on the ice.
For EA Sports, some of the best squads on the planet ready to collide on the ice. Centers are lined up, official ready to drop the puck. The Hurricanes will start with the puck as they win the opening faceoff here. Goes right to the crease. That's gloved by Potman. Lots of time left in this period. Still scoreless in this one. The Hurricanes win the draw. Moves it to McCarr. Stopped by the goaltender, getting a piece of that one.
That wrister had some heat, James, but he was able to get in front of it and turn it aside.
Great forecheck by Taves. Carolina's got possession of the puck. And the puck escapes the zone, and they'll be forced to tag up.
Shot!
Turned aside by Jones. Taken by Thornton. Wow! They got thunderstruck on the play.
He knew exactly what he was doing with that hit this early in the game. He's trying to send a message and dictate the pace.
From point blank! Oh, denies him with the paddle save! Still a lot of time left in the period as we approach the midway mark. We're still scoreless. Back underway as he wins the draw inside the offensive zone. Here's a race for the loose puck. The Maple Leafs gain control of the puck and makes the save. Truba's moving the puck through his own zone. The Maple Leafs gain possession in their own end. Now a quick pass to Matthews. Great heads up play in the defensive zone.
Oh, he just got enough of that to keep it out.
He's gone. Well, talk about a friendly ping right there.
Oh, yeah, it's all about the bounces, isn't it, James? And you got to get the right one, and that one is in his favor. Well, this is just a great job to get the hands away from the body and deflect that puck into the net as it changes direction. Goaltender doesn't have a chance.
Got up by one in the back half of period number one, and they're really starting to assert themselves now here, Cheryl.
You said it. They've been assertive, and they've been dominant in terms of shot share here, James. When they see an opening, they are taking it, and their opponent really doesn't know what to do.
Truva's lugging the puck. The Maple Leafs scoop it up along the boards. Locked him in the open ice.
Momentum.
And that's snapped away in the defensive end by McCabe. Moves it quickly over to Nylander. Carolina's got the puck inside the defensive zone. Across the line. Passes over to Clark. Great read by Dewar. That'll do it for period number one. We'll drop the puck on the second period in just moments. Set to go. Here we go. Middle frame now underway as the puck drops.
Well, Cheryl, how do you sum this one up for the first 20 minutes?
The Maple Leafs are going to need to find the details in their game here, James. They're not winning faceoffs. They're not starting with the puck. And there's a real reason why they're behind.
Look at this. He's jumping right in here for his teammate.
Did you see how quickly he jumped in, too? You can't let your star player go at it, James. And he drops the gloves and sends a message. Hey, leave him alone.
They're still out of breath after that duo, that back and forth action, and they'll just sit for 5 minutes, get some much needed rest. His fighting, it can be exhausting.
Taves can inspire his squad when he lights the lamp, guys. That's his born leader zone ability, and it can really rally the crew.
New Devils Gaming, welcome, brother.
And they win the draw on the offensive zone, and they go to work. The Maple Leafs get a hold of the puck in their own end.
Don't forget to hit that subscribe button too.
He's going to slow things down here and hang on for the whistle.
Well, things happen in and around the net. When you have a lead and you haven't been busy, you hold on. You don't want any mental lapses.
Carolina's been firing on all cylinders here early in this second period, and they continue to lead this one. The Hurricanes win the draw. Picked up along the wall by Konechny. Ahead of steam now towards the front. Just gets enough to keep it out.
He's reading these shooters so well. He's getting in front of them. He's aggressive, and he's challenging them to beat him, James. And that's what I love about him, a ton of confidence.
And look at this. All sorts of pressure here, Fielder. And he hangs on to the puck. Quick pass to Konechny. Oh, just got enough of that to keep it out. And the pass is redirected. Nylander's swooping in on the attack.
Such an impressive save, James. I love to look at these ones again because it's not just being in great position. It's being desperate. It's finding a way to get to the puck, keeping your eye on it at all times, tracking it, out-battling and out-willing everyone around you.
Past the midway mark of the frame, we've got a 1-0 hockey game thus far. Carolina's got a hold of the puck. Here they come.
Confidence on this shot. It's like he knows it's going to make its way through the net with all that traffic in front. So it's all about opening up your own lane and then waiting for that screen to take away the eyes of the goaltender.
The Hurricanes extend the lead to 2-0 now in period number two.
And this is about right, James. They are holding the play. They've maintained possession and they're getting a ton of shots on net. You look up at the scoreboard and you say the right team is winning.
Moves it to the middle. And that's intercepted. The Maple Leafs cross the blue line and are on the attack. And that's turned aside with a glove. Turn that one aside.
They make some consecutive saves there. He's got to be wondering where his defense are. I mean, how about a little help?
Play is blown dead with the offside.
I have to look at the personnel to see who gets the advantage here because it's coincidental, but it's who the team loses that really matters.
Well, things should open up for both sides here with a little 4-on-4 action.
Not typically that we see 4-on-4 action, although it's a lot of fun. You certainly know they practice it in practice. This is something that they're aware of. They know what they're doing. They want to possess the puck and try and create numerical advantage.
And he lowers the boom there. Takes a shot. And there's the save of the play. Here in the late goings of the period, the Hurricanes lead this one 2-0. Less than a minute to go here in the second. Quick feed to Taves. Gains the zone through center. And then
for the puck, and he loses control. Down, still another 20 to go here in this one. Join us for period number 3 next.
To poke the puck away.
Can't keep a hold of it after that hit. And he slides it quickly to Tavares. Here's a chance. Scores! And they finish it on the rebound. What a goal!
James, these are the kind of pesky goals that create a ton of energy for your team. The rebound pops out after the shot. You have to have a hard stick, be heavy on it, with it on the ice, battle and compete for it. He does it, he buries it.
The Maple Leafs desperately needed something, and they finally made it happen.
Well, they're in the final frame here, but they got one back, and you know what that's like as an opponent. When you know that that team is coming and they're a wave, there's a lot of urgency, and they're a dangerous team right now.
Hotface got it and will hang on for the whistle.
Well, he's been so dialed in all game, playing confident and controlled in the crease.
Plenty of playing time left in this frame. The Maple Leafs have answered back in these last few minutes, but still need one more to even the score. Carolina's gained possession along the boards.
Blocked in traffic.
Nearing the point. Picked up along the boards by Tanev.
Into the offensive end, right up the middle.
Play is whistled dead as the puck goes up and over. The Hurricanes have shown no signs of stopping, putting pucks on net, and they lead it here in this third. Off the face-off, they take the puck. And he passes it up ahead to Tucker. And that's broken up by Kuznetsov. That's blocked by Putman. And they'll cover it up, forcing a stoppage in play. Well, here's a little help from a friend.
I love that he jumps in here. Doesn't even give his star player an opportunity to get into this fight. You can't have him fighting and getting injured.
There's the takedown, and I think that might be kind of a mercy rule there, right, Cheryl?
It's a mercy rule as they're exhausted, and you can see them as they're panting. But what it does mean is that the officials can come in and just break it up. The Maple Leafs find a way to send a clear message with that fight. They say, we're not going to be pushed around. We're tough, we're physical, and we're not going anywhere.
A wild couple of minutes there, and things have finally cooled down as both teams will settle in for the faceoff. Tavares has won the draw inside his own end. And that skips away on a nice defensive deflection. Good stand-up hit. Carolina's ready to go on the attack. Good heads-up defensive play as he extends the stick. And that's blocked in traffic. Picks up the puck in his own end. Fires it. Oh, what a stop on the play. Jostles the puck loose. In front of the net, the goaltender covers up for a whistle on the play. The Hurricanes lead it late in this third period.
Okay.
wins the draw inside his defensive zone. Carolina's got a hold of the puck. Along the side, here they come through the neutral zone. Situation critical as they approach the final minute of the third. There's the whistle. We'll get a face-off after the goalie comes up. Set up to go on the attack. He grabs the puck here at the point. Too much congestion blocks the shot. Stops him cold. And that's intercepted by Nylander. They've got some momentum here. What a score! And look at this. We are all back to square one.
Just when you think the game is over, how quickly it can change when you're half urgency. They're all around the net. Everyone is on their feet there as they get the equalizer. Oh, this is such a tough way to give up the lead. You think you have the game, and then you wind up giving it away because you can't protect the middle of the ice.
Both teams are set. They're ready to drop the puck. The Hurricanes win it. Puck picked up by Trouba. Shot! Oh, and he gets a piece of that one to keep it out. And he takes a shot. Big save just as time runs out. Coming up in just a matter of moments.
James, he is so dangerous. He can get it off quick.
Two games in a row, that's bullshit. Oh, holy fuck. Talk about bad luck there. No. I'm gonna straighten that shit up right now. Yeah. Fuck. I'm gonna be taking a quick five. I'll drain the snake, grab some beers, and I'll be right back.
Welcome to EA Sports. I'm James Cebulski. Look at the star-studded talent on display for this Hunt matchup tonight. Yeah, you can just feel the buzz of this city all day long, and we are seconds away now for this opening faceoff. The Avs take possession here on the opening draw, and we are underway. The Maple Leafs have a hold of it in the defensive zone. From center, they get into the attacking area. Good positioning there to knock it away with the glove. Great reflex on display tonight on his part.
He's such a phenomenal shooter, James. I mean, when he shoots in stride, he is absolutely lethal when he pulls that puck in and disguises his shot. He can change the angle so quickly, get it off fast. Goaltender always has to be ready.
Hoffman's great at making reads against wrist shots, guys. His light work zone ability allows him to track those quick releases in order to make the save. It's something to keep an eye out for in this game.
Along the right wing, they enter the attacking area. Rushing to the open ice. Came up with the save on that play.
In order to dictate the tempo of the game right at the onset of it, you want to make...
Yeah, they didn't like that. They're dropping the mitts.
They have to drop the mitts. When you hit their star player, you know he's not going to fight. So who comes in? A physical guy who knows how to drop the gloves and win it.
And there's the takedown, and I think run a moment too soon, at least with one of these fighters.
Yeah, if you're the one that's underneath and on the ice, you want to take your five-minute ticket and march yourself over to the penalty box and get your rest. Both benches showing respect for each of their players that are heading over to the penalty box. That was a tough one. It's purely exhausting to be in a fight like this, and they're just corralling their stuff and getting back to the box.
I think they found the tooth that was lost, and both teams now back inside the faceoff circle. Puck scooped up by McCabe. Through the neutral zone, up along the wing. Denies him with a save. Moves the puck across to Dewar. Takes a spill onto the ice and loses the puck. And he loses control here. A great core strike to hang onto the puck after that.
Is just loving these types of shifts. A lot of pressure and effort in this one.
Oh, they've really got their heads in here in their own zone. And the defenders take possession. Kadri's been brought down, and we're going to get a penalty here. And they get the extra attacker out as the goaltender gets to the bench. Here comes the official's call. Matthews caught red-handed. Tripping is the call.
This power play, and it's his zone ability that could be a difference maker in terms of generating offense here, guys. I'm going to be watching for that.
The Avs win the draw on their own end. They'll want to clear the zone here while they're trying to kill off this penalty. It's a contact sport, people. There's proof right there. They score! A shorthanded goal puts them in front.
Well, the role of the PK is to go out there and stymie the power play. Instead, they go the other way. They recognize the opportunity, and they get a goal. Well, the backhander's going to beat the goaltender on this one, James, but what I love about it is the effort to get to that area, that low-spot area. You know you're going to have to pay the price. You're going to have to fight for position. He does all of it, and he gets rewarded.
Jovi's ready for the draw as we get set to resume this power play. Barbashev's quick stick lands on the puck here at center. Reads the play and forces the turnover. Fires it on net. Too much congestion in front. Thunder is hit in the wall. And that pass attempt is deflected. Grabs the puck here in their own end. Now into the offensive zone from the right side.
Matthews is up and ready to go.
The Maple Leafs man advantage comes to an end, and not the result they were looking for, giving up a shorty. Scores! And we are tied. New game here, Pounder.
Oh, yeah, it's a new game, James. But I really like the pushback to get the equalizer. Now it's what they do with that momentum. This next shift, it's critical. Oh, that's a really tough break for the tender, James. I mean, listen, when structure breaks down and there's all kinds of stuff going on in front of you, you can't track, you can't get your eyes on the puck, and it winds up in the back of your net.
Getting into the later stages of this period, it's all tied up. The Maple Leafs win the faceoff at center.
Riley's going to play it against the half wall. Puck is frozen, and we'll get a face-off.
Edmondson's ice pack zone ability means he can get in those shooting lanes, block shots, and shake it off to stay with the play, guys. It's a hard job to do, but it can really help the squad from getting scored on.
Hughes has the puck inside the defensive zone. Final minute approaching here in this opening frame. On the attack into the offensive end, right up the gut. Slides the puck across to Keller.
And the deadlock is broken as they take the lead.
Well, that's a huge shift, and you can see everyone standing up on the bench. You know how much it means, but it's the next shift that matters most now, James. You want to kind of push and put pressure on your opponent when they're down. Well, this is an unlucky bounce, James. I mean, when you're a goaltender, you play your angles, you know your set positions, but you can't get set in a scramble like this, and it winds up in the back of the net.
The Avs have gone up by one here in the opening frame. How does this now change the complexion of this one?
Well, I think it's really important because they got momentum right now, more jump to their step, and now they'll want to try and stay aggressive and increase that lead, take the momentum, and use it to their advantage.
The Maple Leafs continue to find themselves chasing the game here, James. I mean, you look at the possession numbers, they really haven't had the puck at all, so they're getting worn down right now.
And he's knocked off the puck there. Oh, love the defensive stick work there to poke that one away.
Change up.
Cutting to the slot, and he gets just enough to keep it out.
Well, that shot came quick, and it was right out front. He had to be sharp. He had to be right on it and show his brilliant reflexes.
The Maple Leafs have time to work with, but they need to convert on one of these scoring chances as they are trailing here in the second. The Avs win the draw. Grabbed along the board by Howe. Good defensive effort to push it away. Colorado's got it in their own zone. It looked easy. I don't think anybody was hanging on to the puck after that hit. Here in the back half of this period, it's a 2-1 hockey game. The Maple Leafs win it in the defensive zone. Riley's taking it from his own end. Right side set up ahead into the middle of the ice. Oh, he stops it with the glove. Great reflexes there. There's another stop.
That's a fantastic sequence of saves there. James, he was so dialed in, he tracked it perfectly.
Scooped up along the wall by Thornton. Oh, he got all of that. What a save by the Blue. And this score has really put the pressure on him. Scores! What a finish!
Well, you can clearly see what he means to this group, James. He is a leader. When he's on the ice, everyone is looking for him to lead the charge, and he has a beauty goal, and everyone knows it.
Well, leadership comes in many ways, and for him, it's all about action and leading by example. It's hard work. It's the drive. It's the compete. It's getting to the dirty areas, and everyone on the bench recognize it. You can see that they're celebrating with him right now.
The Maple Leafs have set this up to be a dramatic one tonight.
They put themselves in a good position here at the end of the second period. Listen, it ain't easy to get goals in this game, but they got the equalizer, and it's a nice step heading into the third period.
Here's a short pass to Edmondson. The Maple Leafs have the puck now. And he takes the dish. Takes it into the slot. Just saw what a save that was.
Yeah, he made an incredible save and really engaged this fan base. They're on their feet. You know they're right into the game. And listen, when they are showing you that kind of appreciation, you also want to play for them.
Catch their breath and get ready for a big third period next.
Game. The pressure is on. You have to find a way to embrace it at this moment.
The Maple Leafs take over on possession. Here's a shot. Club save. Oh, and he tracks it perfectly in the offensive end. There's the whistle as the play was offside. Well past the midway mark of this period. We got a tie game. The Maple Leafs win the draw here in the neutral zone. Shot! And he was ready for that one!
Edmondson's back on the ice after serving that five-minute major for fighting, and it's certainly appreciated to have a physical element to your game. You know his teammates certainly appreciate it, but man, you got to find a way to generate offense, and the only way you can is when you're on the ice.
Here's a shot! Oh, right up the cage! And there's a power play opportunity coming up here. Made the save on the play. Whistle blows, stopping the play. The Maple Leafs have been handed two for interference.
Intensity's gonna ramp up to another level because sudden death overtime is coming up.
That's three overtime loss in a row. You can't script that shit. That just doesn't happen. Well, I mean, it just did happen, but I mean, you can't make that shit up. It's not like you could just call up one of your buddies and be like, "Yo, listen, we're gonna go three different teams, right?" No. Doesn't work like that. This is the team I built so far. So 957 wins, 772 loss, 163 overtime wins. Morgan Riley's at 92. Took a while, and I found a 94 Felix Potvin. Oh, dude, definitely bad luck. I can't believe it. For the first time ever in my life, I was like, oh, like, what? Like, when the second one happened, I was like, okay. And then this game, I'm like, oh no, are you kidding me right now? Like, we're going to overtime again? I'm like, this isn't good. This can't be happening to me right now. That's ridiculous. And I'm just like, oh yeah, okay. That's gonna happen, but no, I think I built a pretty solid team. I mixed in players that I've been a Leafs fan since I was in diapers. So to give you guys an idea, alright, that's 36 years and counting. Yeah. Alright. Long time. One time, I remember we had a drought. It was 9 years. Where the Leafs didn't make the playoffs. And like I was harassed at school. Even every time I would represent anything to do with Toronto, I would hear about it, and then it would get me into fights. It would get me into fights in the schoolyard, and it would get me suspended and shit like that. Cause I'm not gonna let them talk shit about my team, right? And growing up as a kid, Felix Potvin, he was my favorite goalie. To me, he was one of my idols. So I got Thornton and Tavares and Darcy Tucker on line one. Matthews, Mitch Marner, Duer are on they're on two. Excuse me. Kadri, I brought back Kadri. I never agreed with Kadri going to Colorado and then from Colorado to Calgary. They should be, you know, trading for him and bringing him back to Toronto. He belongs in Toronto. He don't belong in Calgary. Right? He's fed up in Calgary. I can tell you that right now. Go ring Kadri's Instagram, anybody. Right? Send him an email. Ask him how happy he is in Calgary. He's going to say, I'll tell you no. He'd rather be in Toronto. Right? Max Domi and I got William Nylander. I got bad boy Wendell Clark. Sundin. Reeves. Over here, I got Morgan Riley, right? Brian McCabe, Ilya Lyubushkin, Joel Edmondson, Giordano, I'm gonna swap out, right? Jake McCabe. Giordano turned around and he spent so much time in the penalty box in the last game that we got a bill for rent. So. Put Benoit in there. There we go. Now, you guys see this whole team is pure Leafs. Okay, they're either they were previous Leafs that have played on the team, right? Or they're current and active Leafs. Okay, that's how much I love my Toronto Maple Leafs. Understand? Everything right down to the goaltending. Alright? Now, Felix Potvin is there, and Martin Jones. Alright? Now, if women want to be in the NHL, I have no problem with that, but start off being coaching behind the bench. I don't have a problem with that. This one's been behind the bench most of the season. So, check out Martin Jones. I picked up this 83 Martin Jones how many games ago? 217 games he's played. I've pretty much had Martin Jones the whole entire season. Since October. Yeah. And with all this built up, I only invested $80 into my team at the beginning of the season. That was buying cards. I bought some packs to build the team, to get myself started, so I could keep being competitive, right? But I had to keep upgrading everybody, right? Thank you. I appreciate you guys. Yeah, I mean it was definitely a work of progress. I do have a whole set of Toronto Maple Leaf goalies as well, right? I got Samsonov. All right, I gotta keep my mouth shut. I don't want to get in trouble. I'll talk to you guys after the game.
Welcome to some Hockey Ultimate Team action here on EA Sports. I'm James Cebulski, and these are a couple of fun squads. I'm looking forward to this. Lot of bounce on both blue lines here, and we are about set to drop the puck here at center. The Flames will start with the puck as they win the opening faceoff here. Taken along the wall by McSorley. Through the neutral zone now, picking up steam. Oh! Yzerman's got it against the boards. A chance! And that goes off a player. He's got a step!
Tender to anticipate and get across to make that save.
Centering feed! And that goes off a stick and off target. Makes the easy save with a glove.
Well, he gets a great read on that wrist shot, James, and sometimes it can be difficult because with a quick release, the shot can be disguised, but he does a great job of getting in front of it and making the save.
Oh, another save! Let's get the call.
I think this is a pretty easy call. I mean, you can't get in the way of someone without the puck and impede on their forward movement.
The Flames get their man advantage unit out there for the first time tonight.
First power play opportunity of the game, and to set the tempo, the trend on the specialty team unit.
And too much traffic in front blocks that one. Takes a poke but hangs on to the puck. Levushkin's across the line now and on the attack. Oh, I saved it! What a stop!
Well, that's desperation at its finest to be able to get to that puck and sending a clear message to his team that he's behind him. He's going to be the foundation tonight.
Takes a shot. Just slide to the net. The Maple Leafs have it now. Here inside the defensive zone, they get the puck.
10 seconds left.
Thornton's standing up, ready to go.
The Flames get nothing here on this power play. We're back to even strength.
Demko's last save was outstanding, James. I mean, it was a valiant effort. That's what gets it done. It's beyond the skill to be able to make a save. It is the will and the compete level that energizes everyone around him.
Past the midway mark of the frame, we're still scoreless. The Flames win the defensive zone faceoff.
Huge win by the center to give his team an opportunity to get out of the zone after a critical icing.
The Flames looking against the half wall. Oh, he hit him and got all of it.
Oh, and that's a tough one, James. On the boards, they don't have a lot of give. What that means, you're feeling it all.
Great use of the stick in the defensive end by Hedman. Picked off by McSorley. Skates across the blue line. Deflected away. Nice defensive use of the stick there. The Maple Leafs are in transition.
It's incredible. What an amazing shooter he is, James. He can change the angle of his shot at will. He's one of the best in the leagues at it. But this time, the goaltender read it and made the save.
Moves it over to Stone. Great heads-up play in the neutral zone by McCabe. Big save right at the end. That's it for period number one. Second period action coming up in moments here on EA Sports. opening faceoff here in period number two is about set. Still zeros on the board as we are now underway in the second. All right, Pounder, how would you assess this game through the first 20 minutes played?
The Flames will be a little frustrated after that first period, James. I mean, they held the majority of possession, but they were along the perimeter. You have to drive the paint. You have to get to the scoring areas if you want to put it in the net.
And now he moves it quickly to Bell. Right up Main Street and on the attack. Rocks him into the boards. Takes a shot. Turned aside with a glove by Putman.
And we've got a fight.
Yeah, the physical engagement here has been off the charts, and the discipline has to maintain itself, but a good toe-to-toe fight sends a message.
King, it's all over.
Yeah, the bell has rung, and he certainly got his dung. When the fight started, the fans erupted, and then all of a sudden the tilt went the road team's way, and it got awfully silent in here.
Looks like the emotions have settled down. They've got calm back on the ice, and let's get this puck dropped once again. It's go time! Comes to an end with the takedown.
I think he might be relieved as they head to the ice as he was taking a thrashing.
I think you're right.
The Flames playing very aggressive. That fight right there just showing that they're sending a message, trying to gain some energy, silence the crowd, and really dictate the play.
They've got the debris all cleared up off the ice, and both teams step in for the faceoff. They win the draw and go on the attack.
McStarley's made an incredible play there, James. He stumbles in front of the net, but finds the puck and could have lost it, but manages to stay with it enough to get a shot off.
How did he stop that one?
He does a great job of having sound positional play based on where the puck is on that low inner spot, and he makes himself big, takes away the holes, and makes a save.
The Flames will play it in their own end. And it's a quick pass to Barkov. Moves the puck along the half wall. And a big stick save by the goaltender.
Man, he was right on that puck. He knew exactly where it was. It was tight to the crease.
Scores! The icebreaker goal, and finally we have one in this game.
Yeah, it took a while, James, but they found the back of the net, and it's still the first one in the game, so the opponent is hunting. As a goaltender, you're always working on different exercises, tracking with your eyes, foot movements, everything. That power pushes you across the crease, and unfortunately this time he's just too slow getting across, and it hits him and goes to the back of the net.
The Maple Leafs deserve a lot of credit here, breaking through with the first goal. They didn't get frustrated, they just stayed with the game here, Cheryl.
And they needed to, James, because they...
And we've got a fight!
His weight over him and takes him down to the ice, and he's going to be the victor in this one. The Maple Leafs keeping their fan base in this game, and anytime there's a fight, you can feel the energy in the building, especially when you're the home team. It's electric in here.
Well, both teams seem to be a little calmer now after a pretty chaotic stretch just a few moments ago. Tavares has won it here at center. The Flames gain possession in their own end. Pushes it across to Hedman. And he slides it quickly to McKinnis. Traps that puck tight to his chest. And we're going to get a stoppage here as the referee blows the play dead. Past the midway mark in this period, we've got a 1-0 hockey game thus far. Well, that's one way to win the draw. He skates away with the puck after the two centers were tied up. Toronto's looking to break out. Shot! Denied by the puck stopper. Goaltender covers it up and we'll get a reset here. Here in the late goings of the period, Toronto's ahead 1-0. Tavares won the draw and they'll start off on the attack. Denied by Demko. Picked up along the wall by Bell. Looking to make something happen at center. Directed over to Yzerman. Rips it from the point. And the goaltender comes up with a piece of it to keep it out of the net.
He makes a great read on that puck, James. I mean, the quick release wrist shot, that's a tough one to stop. All the shooter wants to do is catch him off guard, get him behind you, but he gets square to it.
Centers glide into the dots. We're ready to get things back going again. And there's the horn bringing an end to period number two. Still 20 minutes more of action in the third. Stick around.
Chances, a lot of room on the ice. They know when to drive the play, but they just haven't been able to solve the tending.
Oh, wow! Stops again!
What a sequence. I mean, he has been outstanding, making consecutive saves. I mean, his defense, they gotta start playing.
Lots of time left in this period. Toronto's up 1-0. Yzerman's won the draw. And that's the scores! Centers are set, face-off ready to resume play. Yzerman's quick stick lands on the puck here at center. The Flames will play it from the defensive zone. Slides the puck ahead to Dunn. Moves it quickly over to McSorley. Makes his presence known on the ice. Toronto's got it into the offensive zone. Picked up along the boards by Thornton. Here he is in close. Too many bodies in the way. Moves the puck up to Stone. Off a stick and they can't connect. Here's a chance. Easily turned aside by Potman.
No question, the goaltenders know who the shooters are in the league and what style of shot they take, and he's able to get a perfect read on the shooter here. That quick release shot, he knew that wrister was coming all day long.
Fires it, and that goes wide. Grabbed along the board by Barkov. There's the whistle, we got an offside. Oh,
More than half the period has gone by. Hope you're enjoying this one. It's all tied up. They take possession as he locks them up off the faceoff. The Flames move the puck in the defensive zone. Quick pass to Hedman. Feeds it to Barkov. Intercepted at center by Marner. Moves it to the offensive zone. Shot! And that caroms off a body in traffic. Barkov stick handling in his own zone. Scooped up along the wall by Mikheyev. Icing is the call. We'll get a face-off at the other end. This is a face-off. They'll definitely want to win here inside the offensive zone. And off the draw, they'll take possession. The Flames have it from their own end. Quick feed to Barkov. And now it's over to McDonald. Quick shot with the stop. Referee's hand goes up in the air. We got a delayed penalty coming up here. Wow, the home team is really under pressure, and the fans know it. There's the whistle, and here's the call.
Well, this is a real curveball at the end of a third period, isn't it? Your PK unit has to go out there in a tie game with all the pressure on them and find a way to sacrifice and kill it off.
And they'll roll the power play unit right back out. And they'll start with possession. Tucker's crossed the line and is on the attack now. Great reach with the poke check by Dunn. Big stop just as time expires in the period. There's the horn for regulation, and it solves nothing. Overtime coming up right after this.
Makes him a good offensive threat, guys. Let's see if he uses that to his advantage here in overtime.
The Flames take possession here inside the offensive zone. Trips it and rips it. Oh, excellent play and goal there. Oh, and a misfires. He's got the game on his stick. Stopped and will play on.
Oh, he's so frustrated at that. He wanted to be the hero.
A chance in the rush here. Here's a pass. What a save. And they're going to go after that. And drops the hammer on that one.
Yeah, the clear winner as that final punch perfectly executed in a tough one on the other end.
Well, he looks visibly shaken here after taking a couple of punches, James. That's a tough one, and it's the danger of fighting.
A big face-off here inside the offensive end.
Up
The Flames win the draw. Now let's see what they can do with it. From the left side, they gain the zone. Chance in front. Scores! What an opportunity and delivers! And that'll close the book on this one as the final horn sounds. Toronto's got to be pleased with this win tonight, Cheryl. This was a hard-fought affair.
You said it, James. I mean, they closed quickly on their opponent. They played extremely physical, and I just feel like they won more of the puck battles. A salute, a thank you, which has gone down as tradition for this team to be able to say, hey fans, you've been there all the way.
That'll do it for tonight's EA Sports broadcast. Hey, look, plenty of action just around the corner, and we hope to see you then. Good night.